Hello. Dear students, very good morning, Jai Hind. Very good morning and welcome back to our e-learning session today. Today, you are attending lecture number 6 in chapter 4 of chemistry, that is carbon and its compounds. Okay, before we start our today's lecture number 6, some of the very important points which I also discussed with you in previous lecture. Understand, as far as this particular chapter of chemistry is concerned, the chapter is little difficult to understand also. At the same time, it is little difficult to remember also. Understand? So what I guided you throughout all the lectures so far in this particular chapter, that each and every time the lecture gets over in the topic, you have to revise the topic thoroughly from our material. Understand, because develop this particular habit as far as this chapter continues, because in this particular chapter, if you just think that lecture is over, homework is over, and you are not going to prepare or learn all words or all sentences I have spoken throughout the lectures, then when you are going to prepare at the time of test, this chapter you will find most difficult to learn. In actually, why I have given you guidance, understand initially also that chapter, lecture over, do homework, and on the same day read the topic of the homework thoroughly, word to word. Not only you read thoroughly word to word, but understand each and every word clearly. Understood? In lecture 1, suppose we discussed about covalent bond in carbon. So if you read that topic thoroughly, then you are able to generate, give reason, explain the statement with scientific reason yourself. Suppose I ask you, explain, which we discuss in lecture 1, carbon is not able to make C-4 anion. Why? Give reason, 2 marks. Carbon is not able to make C+4 cation. Already reason. This is the way you need to prepare this chapter. Understand? In lecture number 2, you all know we discussed about some covalent bonding, that is formation of mono, double, triple covalent bond. As you know, that we studied in detail. Understand? So on the same day, the topic gets over, do your homework, understand material what is given in the textbook, that has been modified a lot by us in our material, so that you can understand the sentence formation properly. Understood? Then, as you all know, in our lecture number 3, we targeted the topic, and those topic continued for 3 lecture 3, 4 and 5, where we discussed about what? So we discussed about saturated and unsaturated compounds. We discussed about branch, chain and ring structure, understand? And we also discuss about versatile nature of carbon. Suppose, my dear student, I ask a question, which two from that lecture 3, which two specific property of carbon makes it so versatile among the element? So those two property, can you answer me? One, catenation, and another, tetravalency. Understand? We discussed about alkane, homologous series of alkanes, homologous series of alkenes, homologous series of alkynes also. They are not mentioned properly in textbook. In textbook only, homologous series, somewhat 3 to 4 paragraph they have explained. And they have just said the word that such homologous series can be observed in alkane, alkene, alkyne. But in our material, we have given you separate short note. Write a short note on alkane series, alkene series, homologous series of alkynes that way. Understand? So be very conscious in this particular chapter. Lecture over. Understand? The moment lecture gets over, that means before you complete the homework, attend the lecture properly. Note down each and every point in your notebook. Refer topic 2 to 3 times from material. Understand each and every word and then complete your homework and submit. This is the process you need to adopt in this particular chapter. That means, my dear student, what I want, 5 lectures over in this chapter. Ano matlab, a 5 lecture nu jetlu content has been given to you needs to be thoroughly prepared by you before we move to lecture number 6. Okay, my dear student. So today we are attending actually chapter 4. You all know, let me mention the name of the chapter. Ghana bhuli gaya se. The name of the chapter, as you all know, my dear student, carbon and its compounds. That's the name of the chapter. Okay. And today you are attending in this particular chapter of chemistry, one of the largest chapter in chemistry, like matter, like acid, base and salt. Understand? Lecture number 6 today. You are attending lecture number 6, and today, my dear student, we are going to discuss a few important words. Understand? Which are those important words which we are going to discuss today? Understand, in our lecture number 6 today. One more thing. Yesterday, in our lecture number 5, I have already taught you regarding alkene series and alkyne series. At that time, as far as alkenes are concerned, can you recite those name of the alkenes again? Ethene, propene, butene, pentene, hexene. In our lecture number 5, we have understood only all 3 types of formulas of ethene only. But at least what I suppose is that you should remember at least all formulas of first 2 member of series. Understand? Alkene, you know, ethene, you know. Let us try to make and understand the formula of next member of alkene series. That is, I am just writing the title for you only, so that you will come to know that we are discussing about alkene series only. Okay. About ethene we already discussed out. Okay. And I am just writing the name ethene so that it becomes clear in your mind. Today we want to discuss all three types of formula as far as propene is concerned, the second member in the alkene series. You all know, because this question can be asked in 2 marks or sometime even in 3 marks also. Write all types of formulas of propene. What is the molecular formula of propene? You all know. Understand ethene, you all know. Can you remember ethene? If you don't remember ethene, you remember ethane. What is that? C2H6. Subtract 2 hydrogen, formula of ethene, C2H4. Now propene, as I told you, there is a difference of CH2. So C3H6, you understood, no? So that's the molecular formula of propene. Okay. Let us try. Why I am teaching this? Because in future when you practice regarding butene, pentene, hexene, maybe in higher standard, so at that time at least some concept, just now you have, in as far as the textbook material is concerned, they have just given all types of formula of ethene only. But at least, suppose in board exam they ask one more member, though it is not in textbook, propene, so at that time you should be sure about how to make its all types of formula. Molecular formula I have already written here. C3H6, that's the molecular formula of propene. Okay, my dear student, let us try to make its structural formula. What I suggested, whenever you want to make structure of any compound, maybe alkane, alkene or alkyne, what is the basic concept? To draw structure of any organic compound, you should know carbon skeleton. Here in ethene or in propene, how many carbon atom you can visualize? 3 carbon atom. And as you know, alkene has double covalent bond. What is the definition of alkene? Those hydrocarbon having where there exists double covalent bond between 2 adjacent carbon atom. Mind it, that was the definition. It doesn't mean that when you saw the structure of propene, everywhere you saw double covalent bond between every 2 successive carbon atom, that you do not have to do. That's why I am taking the topic propene. Let us first draw carbon skeleton of propene. Okay, dear student, concentrate here. There are 3 carbon that you all know. You have to show double covalent bond. Okay, so my dear student, be concentrating. Double covalent bond can be shown here. Here you do not have to show double covalent bond. Understand, this concept has to be very clear in your mind. That's why I have taken. It doesn't mean that suppose butene, so butene has four carbon atom, so you are not able to show everywhere double covalent bond. You have to show covalent bond, understand, only at one location. Okay, carbon skeleton we have already drawn, my dear student. Now rest process, you know, satisfaction of tetravalency of carbon. First carbon, its two valencies are occupied. How many valency it has left? Two valency, where it covalently bonds with hydrogen. Now my dear student, concentrate on second carbon atom. Two valency are occupied here, one valency here, only one hydrogen covalently bonds. Third carbon atom has one valency already occupied, understand, with second carbon, so it has three valencies free, so everywhere you can show H. This is the way structure of propene can be made. You understood this? Okay, electronic dot structure, if somebody ask you, my dear student, you all know, just write carbon skeleton. Okay, here single bond means one electron pair and hydrogen. Draw with me, one electron pair and hydrogen, two electron pair here, one electron pair and hydrogen here, one electron pair here. Okay, now here one electron pair and hydrogen, one electron pair and hydrogen, one electron pair and hydrogen. So we have already drawn electron dot structure of propene. At home you can try to make all types of formulas of butene, pentene, hexene by yourself, but when you make the formula, doesn't mean that you will show double covalent bond everywhere between any two adjacent carbon atom. Mind this as a practice, and SLP, which we call self-learning practice, you can do, but as far as the exam point of view is concerned, at least you should be able to remember at least first two member of alkene series, that is ethene and propene. Okay, my dear student, next, yesterday, if you can remember, we have yesterday also discussed about alkyne series, if you can remember. Alkyne series, and in alkyne series, we have, yes, in lecture number 5, understand, we have already understood three types of formula of ethyne, if you can remember. If I ask you to recite all members of alkyne series, can you speak out? Ethyne, propyne, butyne, pentyne, hexyne, understand? Ethyne, you all know, and we have discussed in our lecture also, its molecular formula, its structural formula, its electron dot structure also, that we all know about ethyne. My target is at least two member of every series, understand, needs to be clear in your mind. Okay, so my dear student, let us try to recite, okay, again, alkyne series, okay, at least let us try to understand. To ethyne, you all know, dear student, you can remember formula of ethyne. Main tumne gai kal, what I told you, that be tricky. In organic chemistry, the student who are smarter and tricky are always able to remember the content more than the other student. You never have to just learn only formula, be tricky to get it. Ethane, suppose you don't know, understand? Ethane, we don't know. Ethane, you know, you don't know. Ethane, okay, you know, yes. C2H6, subtract 2 hydrogen atom, C2H4, subtract 2 hydrogen atom, C2H2. Le bani gayi formula. If you forgot in exam or during test, what is the formula of what is the formula of ethane? So at least you remember the formula of ethane. That is C2H6, successively go on subtracting or reducing 2 hydrogen atom, ethane C2H4, ethane C2H2, understand? Once you get ethane, then my dear student, it becomes very customary for you, understand? Propane, what is the difference between 2 successive alkynes? What is the difference between 2 successive alkynes? CH2. So can you guess the formula of propyne? C3H4. We got the formula of propyne. Ketlu tricky kariye chhe apne. Kyare pan. Anytime. Never look the organic chemistry, understand, with never feel it boring. Be tricky in remembering. Nobody is asking you how you remember the formula. It's the way you should develop your short way to remember all the formula. Ethene you don't know. Ethane you don't know. Ethane to you know. So just subtract 2 hydrogen atom. You are able to get the formula of propyne. C3H4. You got the molecular formula. After getting molecular formula of propyne, let us try to make its structure and its electron dot structure. What I told you, whenever you want to draw structure of any compound, you have to be very sure regarding carbon chain, or to be more specific and proper, carbon skeleton, that you should know, understand. So in propyne, how many carbon atoms you are able to visualize here? 3 carbon atom already, understand. Let us try to its structure. See, no doubt there are 3 carbon atom. Because you are going to draw structure of one of the alkyne already, so somewhere you have to show triple covalent bond. Don't show triple covalent bond everywhere between any 2 successive carbon atom. Be very alert and sure about that. So here in propyne, there will be 3 covalent bond here and only 1 covalent bond here. You understood? The carbon skeleton has been drawn. Now the rest is the satisfaction of valency of carbon. First carbon has got its 3 valencies occupied in this 3 covalent bond. So it has only 1, understand, valency left, which where you can show hydrogen. Second carbon atom, student are not able to sometime remember the formula. The basic is they are not becoming tricky in remembering the formula. I am utilizing the word that after you draw carbon skeleton, you have to satisfy carbon valency and carbon is tetravalent. So my dear student, your attention has to be four bonds has to be there around carbon. First carbon has already covalently bonded in this three covalent bond, so it has only one valency left where you can show hydrogen. You show hydrogen here or here, it's all okay. Second carbon atom has how many valencies already occupied? Check this. Three valencies are covalently bonded here. One electron is covalently bonded here. So middle carbon atom here has got all valencies satisfied. Now concentrate on third carbon atom. It has got only one valency occupied. So how many valencies are still free to be bonded? So three valency. So I can show three hydrogen here. Okay. So this is the structure of propyne. You understood this? If you want to draw electron dot structure, my dear student, you all know very well. Just one electron pair here and so hydrogen. Okay, here are three covalent bond, so you will show three electron pair here. Here single covalent bond means one electron pair. Here single covalent bond with hydrogen. Here single covalent bond with hydrogen. Here single covalent bond means one electron pair with hydrogen. Understood? So this is the way electron dot structure of propyne can be formulated. Why I have taken the structures of propene and propyne so that in future when you want to formulate structure of any alkene or alkyne by yourself, you have to be very very sure how to construct it. No doubt for the exam point of view, you need to remember only two, that is ethene and propene, ethane and propyne, that is sufficient. Okay, my dear student, this is what somewhat left and we have taken it so that last year also some student has query regarding ethene and ethane are already given in textbook, but they had query regarding propene and propyne, and that time I already solved it. So here before your query may arise, you have to remember propene and propyne, all three structures. Okay, this is necessary for you. Okay, my dear student, right, is it clear? Now let us take another topic today which is very very important, and that topic which we are going to discuss now. Understand, let me first write the title itself. That is, title is functional group. Okay, functional group. Actually in textbook the title is given, will you be my friend? Understand, that means we do not have to make friend. Actually the title is given in textbook, that is what's the title actually, will you be okay my friend? What does it mean? This is a total topic regarding carbon. Okay, dear student, and actually carbon is so friendly in nature that he wants to be develop friendship with any element of the nature, any, And that's why the versatility is observed regarding carbon compounds in nature. As you know, 3 million known by formula, understand, no element can do this, right? So one important thing, that is the versatile nature of carbon. Okay, what actually I told you, that carbon has capacity of catenation, tetravalency. Not only that, carbon has capacity to make a linear chain, branched chain, or ring-like chain structure, that you all know. Carbon has all these three properties we know. Carbon can join, means carbon can make covalent bond with any other element. It can make covalent bond with hydrogen, to chhe, with oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, halogen to mention. You know halogens? Understand, halogens means chlorine, bromine, fluorine, iodine. They all are called halogens. So carbon can also form bond with these halogens. Understand? Here one particular word I have mentioned, understand, that is functional group. Actually, what is the meaning of functional group? Group itself suggests that it is going to be group of something, understand? So actually functional group means what? Functional group means group of atom. To understand, my dear student, functional group means what? It means group of atoms. Understand? A little bit, but like you studied the polyatomic ion, where also you will see the group of atom, if you can remember, right, my dear student? Group of atom. Why they are called? We understood the meaning of group. Group means the group of atom. But why they are called by this particular specific name, functional group? Why? So my dear student, try to understand. Whenever such functional group covalently bonds with carbon atoms, it may be a linear chain, it may be a branched chain, it may be a ring-like chain, whatever. But whenever this functional group joins with carbon, no doubt by substituting one hydrogen atom, just I show you one, okay, suppose, no doubt that we are going to discuss later on in substitution reaction, but just you, suppose, you all know the formula of methane, what is that? CH4, okay? Let me write the structure of methane. This is the structure of methane, you all know? Okay, you all know that methane has got specific properties which you studied somewhere in previous standard also. Methane has its own specific property. Now what happens? Just now it is methane and possess all specific property of solely of methane itself. Now suppose, my dear student, try to understand, if one hydrogen atom from methane, suppose this, is substituted by one of the functional group, suppose I take chlorine, okay, suppose, halogen, understand, you all know the name of halogens, chlorine, then fluorine, then bromine, then iodine, all are actually all are halogens. So if this hydrogen atom is substituted by this chlorine atom, which also we can call functional group, then the new compound by this substitution reaction will be CHHH. One hydrogen is substituted by chlorine atom. Okay. So what happened? Because it is substituted by chlorine atom, my dear student, entirely a new compound is formed. If I just write its molecular formula, jo kai rite lakhay, C, how many hydrogen? 3, to am lakhvanu, CH3Cl, su bani gyu. Initially it was methane and possessed all specific properties of methane only. But now due to substitution by this chlorine, it became a new compound which actually called methyl chloride. What you can say? Methyl chloride, okay? Or you can say chloromethane, understand? Now what happened? This is totally a new compound formed and it has totally different property than methane. Understand why methane acquired totally different property? Because this particular atom by substitution of hydrogen atom gave rise to a totally new compound. That's why this atom is called heteroatom or functional group. Why heteroatom? Because just by their presence they change the property of particular organic compound. Understand? Right? So what are functional group actually? They are such heteroatoms or group of atom. Whenever such group of atom joins with any carbon chain, may it be linear, branch, ring, it confer totally different properties. Means I can say such group of atom or heteroatom actually dictates the property of the chain or a change in the property of the compound, irrespective or regardless of whatever chain of carbon atom may be. Understand? That's why they are called functional group. Why functional group? Because just by joining with any carbon chain, they dictate totally different property to that organic compound. Ethane has its own property, but when substituted by bromine, it become ethyl bromide, totally new property. Understand? So functional group are those heteroatoms or group of atom which when joins with any carbon chain, it totally changes the it actually rules on the property of that original particular compound. Understand? They are known as functional group. You have to remember name of some of the functional group, okay? Some of the functional group has been mentioned in your textbook and some I may also mention here, okay? Some of the functional group, let us try to write it here. In material also we have given it, okay? Functional group, suppose if we take functional group, okay, and suppose I write symbols here, so some of the functional group we have to remember. A halogen I am not writing because we know about halogen. Chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine, all are halogen. So I write just next functional group we need to remember, actually it is called alcohol group. Understand, written alcohol, but particularly you should tell it hydroxyl group. What you should tell it? Hydroxyl group, okay? Hydroxyl group. Okay, now let me write the formula of, symbol means formula of hydroxyl group. You have to write OH. Remember, my dear student, formula you need to remember. Alcohol, that is hydroxyl group, it is actually a heteroatoms group, OH. Understand, you need to remember hydroxyl group. Let us write another group, that is, let me write ketone, that is also another group, ketone. You have to remember name of four functional group mentioned in textbook. One halogen that you know, chlorine, bromine, iodine, fluorine, whatever. Alcohol, that means hydroxyl group, OH. Understand, then ketone group, if we take ketone, okay? So my dear student, how will you show ketone group? Actually its formula is CO, but you have to move as per textbook, to C double O, understand, and this way. Whenever in exam you are asked to write formula of ketone group, you have to write this way. You can see four valences of carbon are satisfied. This is carbon chain and here double bond O. Ketone group you have to remember. Another group, my dear student, which has been mentioned, understand, that is carboxylic acid. Actually we will call it carboxyl group. Okay, carboxyl group, understand. So actually if you want to write the formula of carboxyl group, it can be written as COOH. Do you remember one of the acid, acetic acid, what is the formula? CH3COOH. You understood this? This shows carbon chain and this shows particular carboxylic group, and that's why it became acetic acid. Understood? So here carboxylic group, formula COOH, but how will you show C double bond O? One valency of carbon to be satisfied here and one to be satisfied here. Okay, so this is the way you can show carboxylic group. You understood this, right? Here also, so yes, COOH, you have to show this here only. Okay, my dear student, here you will show it. Okay, here you have to show OH, COOH, that is carboxylic group. There are some other functional group also, just for your knowledge, just writing those formula only, amino group. That is not in textbook, but just for your knowledge, amino group, NH2. Then amide group, that is NHCO, just note it down. Then ester group, just note it down, COO. So these are some functional group which actually confers or dictates the property of the compound formed by substitution. Understand? So this is somewhat discussion about functional group. Why I discussed in detail, because it happened in exam that you may be either in 2 marks or in 3 marks. If you are asked the question, what are functional group, explain in detail. So my dear student, you have to be very sure regarding those scientific terminology I am utilizing, that this group of atom are called heteroatoms. They will substitute hydrogen atom and give rise to a new compound from carbon chain, may be linear, branched or ring-like, and this new compound possess entirely different chemical properties. Understand? That's why, because these heteroatoms confer totally new property to particular compound, that's why they are known as functional group. This is the way you will write 7 to 8 sentence, and then you will just draw the table where you will show some functional group. Okay, dear student, this is the way you have to prepare. Understand? So in today's lecture, what we have discussed, lecture over, the topic needs to be thoroughly prepared. Nowhere in textbook you will find this formula which we discussed about propene, propyne, functional group. So no doubt there is in our material. Okay, right? So in today's lecture we covered 3 topics. Okay, in the next lecture we are going to continue nomenclature of organic compound. Understand? And then we have to discuss about properties of organic compound, then properties of ethanol and ethanoic acid. The chapter is no doubt lengthy but interesting, and